Everyone, welcome to a Mango stream sponsored by Channel Fireball and Ultimate Guard. The complaint today is called Affinity because it has a lot of cards with affinity for artifacts. We have Thoughtcast, Thought Monitor, Mirror Enforcer, Sojourner's Companion, Frogmite. The new addition to the deck is Treasure Ball. This card resided in the D&D set in the Adventures of the Forgotten Realms. And it's basically a Darksteel Citadel. It's an artifact land that adds for colorless. So it basically like a double land for the affinity cards. And it also has a second ability, which is pay XX, sacrifice this, make X tokens, which I'm not expecting this to be that effective, but I mean, you can like pump your Crania plating maybe. But anyway, this is basically counting as an additional Dark Citadel. Remember that, like Seat of Synod or Vault of Whispers or Band in Modern. So having a new comes into play untapped land. And why I say that, because with Modern Horizons, we've had this like Mistfall Bridge, which comes into play tapped, which doesn't seem great. But if you look at the deck, everything costs zero or one or has affinity. So basically, this comes into play land are like regular land for the more expensive cards. The only problem with this is like Springleaf Drum or Crania Plating. So basically, if you look at this deck, you can look at it this way. You have hand cards that require you to tap like old-fashioned mana to be cast. And everything else gets around that because you have 15-0 drop with Welding Jar, Paradise Mantle, Ornithopter, Bubble, and Memnite. And then you have 17 cards with affinity, meaning that Treasure Vault and Darksteel Citadel in this deck are actually just double lands. A Mistfall Bridge, it's a single land when it comes into play and then a dual land later. You, of course, have Urza's Saga as well. And Urza's Saga in this deck is fantastic because, we all know why Urza's Saga is great, but you have the ability to make a Construct Token, and in this deck, Construct Token is really large. You can just like go very, very wide very soon with this deck. I like this deck a lot. And of course, this deck suffers artifact hate. So cards like Ataki, cards like, you know, Collector Oof, Stone of Silence and whatnot will definitely hurt you. Even more now that Treasure Bolt is an additional artifact land and you remove like the Glimmer Void or stuff like that. But yeah, in the sideboard, I'm mono blue. The only black that you see is Mistfall Bridge is because you want to maybe attach this Crania Plating instant speed. You have Dismember. This is like your colorless way to deal with turn one Ragavan, for example. Usually I board in Dismember for Thoughtcast and Etch a Chamber for Mirror Enforcer against the Ragavan decks. You have 4 Metallic Rebuke when needed, a couple of Damping Sphere, and then you have some Singleton to pick up with the Urza's Saga with Pithy Needle, Cage, and Lantern. Cat Gatherer, thank you so much for the Twitch Prime sub. Welcome. Good morning, and hope you're having a nice good week. Since it's starting now, it's Monday. All right. Well, this is my deck. I am actually excited to play it out. I really like the look at it. I used to play Emery. In the past. I decided to cut it for Thoughtcast. So the reason why I loved Emery was because you could cast her on turn one or two, whereas sometimes Thoughtcast could like be stacking in with the rest of the seven drops if you didn't have enough. Maybe like later in the game it would have been insane, whereas Emery can just die to removal spell. But Emery is that card that you can deploy along with the rest. So it's a one mana threat that you can deploy together. In this deck, I decided to play more Mirror Enforcer and more Thoughtcast because I have 4 additional artifact land in Treasure Vault. So I really want to go all in on Affinity now. And not just a little bit. So yeah, Frogmite, Sojourner's Companion, Mirror Enforcer. They might not be great on the surface, but when you just jam so many of them at turn like 2 or 3, you will definitely feel the power of them. All right. Pretty excited. I have done very well with Affinity on stream. 2 trophies. I made 2 trophies with Affinity, and it was before the Treasure Vault, so I'm actually pretty excited to try it out. And I hope it plays well. All right. Yeah, there's some questions about whether I'm not why I'm not playing Nettlecyst. Nettlecyst is another card that's definitely worth talking about. Okay, so Nettlecyst is this like cranial plating that costs three and costs two to equip, but it gives also toughness and it gives. Oh, sorry, what's the. Isn't it nettle? No, I guess it's not nettle. I definitely own it. Do I not own it? Maybe I don't know how to pronounce it, that card. I thought it was Nettlecyst. All right, anyway, we found an opponent, so let's go ahead and play. Does Affinity work against Tron? I guess so. I guess so. Khan the Great Creator might be annoying, of course. Anything that disrupts your activated ability of artifacts is annoying. Khan the Great Creator, Collector, Oof, Stony Silence. There's a lot of those. Okay, let's take a look at this hand. You have to kind of like think about your hand a lot with this deck. Well, I'm going to keep, but this is definitely in need of something. All right, Braiding Pool on the other side. Urza Saga number two. Okay. Now, we might play Urza Saga on turn one. The reason being, ooh hoo boo, we got a huge raid from Caleb. Thank you. Thank you so much, Caleb. And welcome, Raiders. And welcome, supporters. Thank you so much to Grost for the 3rd month sub. You got an espresso badge. All right, all right. Thank you for the support, guys. Welcome. Thank you, Caleb. Of course, we're playing Affinity, and this is the first game of the first match. Playing Affinity with the Treasure Vault. That is the innovation. So I'm thinking about whether I want to go Urza Saga Gingerbrute. So if I play Urza Saga turn one, that means that I won't be able to get a I won't be able to get a construct on turn two, which is not ideal, but I can still play like a Mistful Bridge and then get a construct on the third turn. I think overall it's the better option, considering that as Urza's Saga expires, it can get me a can go get me a Springleaf Drum, which I can attack with. Buongiorno, buongiorno. Gingerbrute isn't the most amazing card you can play modern, of course. It's a one-off that you can get with Urza Saga. Gingerbrute can be unblockable, and Cranial Plating can deal you chunk of damage, so it's nice to have one. Okay, Ornithopter. Ornithopter isn't bad. Now I can deploy Ornithopter tap land. I don't think it's ideal. I do not think it's ideal. I am unfortunately unable to make a construct next turn with this saga. Since if I play this land tapped, I don't have three mana in my next main phase. Remember that you can't you have to get three mana next turn. So what I'm doing here is just cast another saga. I think my opponent is playing Crushing Footfalls, by the way. I'll just go to combat first. Hello, Koyax. He's left terribly. I'm sorry. He's left okay. And then I'll play Cranial Plating. I'll play Ornithopter. I'll play Frogmite. And I'll pass. Now, next turn, I'll be able to flow mana with this Urza Saga, the one that's expiring, and go get a Springleaf Drum. That way, I'll have three mana to make a construct. Watch out for my opponent. Hope my opponent isn't playing Living Get but Footfalls. They go Stomp. Okay, that's fine with me. Whenever this deck doesn't draw Spring Leaf Drum, it's just slow. All right. Now they have the card Shardless Agents that's cascading into footfalls, putting a 10 power, 10 toughness for 3 mana. That's very good. But this deck will slowly just assemble power here. Okay, they have 5 cards in hand. They just played Bone Crusher. Cool. Now, main phase, and this thing will evolve. Right, so the saga's going to get me mana, and then it will die. And the other one will go to 2. Now, if I get an artifact, I will for sure get Springleaf Drum since I need lands and need mana here. Springleaf Drum is basically a mox. Okay. Now, what are we doing? Let me just make a construct here. I can also I keep plating. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'll get 6, 7, so I'll be able to deploy both of this. Right, so let's make a construct. That will be my sixth artifact. Now Mistfall Bridge is the 7th, and I'll be able to deploy both of this. Let's go ahead and play both of them. And now my opponent doesn't play the Living End, so this is good. Now I have a 9/9 construct. Next turn, I can get Shadow Sphere with this other saga to make the powerful combo Cranial Plating plus Shadow Sphere. Let's watch out for Cryptic Command from my opponent, though. I could also not make the construct and the keep instead, but yeah, maybe that was better. All right, I'm going to pass this, so now I have to be worried about Cryptic Command. Okay, now I'll just make a construct. I believe there's no point to I think there's no point to not do it. Now that saga dies and goes get me a what do I want to get here? I can get Bubble to draw a card. I can get Shadow Spear to gain some life. Yeah, Welding Jar, I don't think it's relevant. I might just draw a card with Bubble here. It's either that or the Shadow Spear. I think I'm fine with just a Bubble. Now play Treasure Vault. Let me go ahead and keep this Cranial Plating to the top there and go to combat. If they have Cryptic Command, it's fine. Yeah, they basically they are in a spot where they can't really escape what I'm doing here. Even if they Cryptic this turn, like next turn, I'm also again applying lethal. All right, now winning game one, it's not hard for this deck. The problem of this deck is certainly the plus sideboard at games. Where my opponent will have to just bring in graveyard hate, such as Force of Vigor and so on and so forth. Now, well, Damping Sphere means that if they want to go Cascade Spell into Rhinos, they need to spend an extra mana, but I don't think that's relevant. You're talking about Void Mirror there. Void Mirror is definitely annoying, although I do have 10 colors of mana, and I guess there's a saga getting drum, so it's basically 14 colors of mana. So I'm not that afraid of of Void. Actually, no, they can't play Void Mirror because they have to play Cascade. They can't play Void Mirror nor Chalice of the Void if they're a Cascade deck. I mean, I guess I could bring in a couple of Metallic Rebuke. It's generally okay to sideboard a Mirror Enforcer, considering that post-sideboard, your opponent will disrupt your plan and it'll be a little harder to get affinity, so you don't want to be stumbled with them. But I don't want to overload on this. So I'll just submit this list and move on. It's very important to not over-sideboard with affinity. Okay, I'll go ahead and keep this hand. Doesn't have the most explosive early game, but as always, the late game will definitely be premium. I love to play Affinity. It's really just it's been one of my favorite decks since Urza Saga was around. It's also the deck that kind of got me the best result on Magic Online at this like friendly league I'm playing. Suspend the Crashing Footfalls, which is good. You can't really go do that with Living End. Drawing Crashing Footfalls is actually a play that's not a bad play. Remember that Art Sojourner's Companion can be cycled to get like either a Darksteel Citadel or a Mistful Bridge. Now I have four artifacts, but I don't have much going on after that. I think I'm just deploying the Darksteel Citadel, the Mishra's Bubble, and I'll just pass. I don't want to show the rest. They don't play Chalice or anything like that. So I'm just cracking this bubble because I want to draw blue mana here. They have a Scalding Tarn on top, sure, and I'll just pass the turn. Against what deck do I want to play Set of Rebukes? I guess control decks? Combo decks? Is my opponent a combo deck? I don't think it is. Okay, Cranium Plating. Sojourner's Companion, number two. Not great. I think I'm just getting a artifact land with this. Not the most impressive start, but my draws haven't been nice. Okay. They don't have the thing. Yeah, Modern Horizons 2 has revitalized Magic. I think Magic was in a pretty bad shape. But Modern Horizons 2 has made so that kind of every format that got involved with Modern Horizons 2 is very good. All right. Treasure Volcanic Treasures. I guess I'm taking this over the Darksteel Citadel. This one can be blown up by Force of Negation, so I'm just getting the Darksteel Citadel instead. All right, you're getting two rhinos in play. You want a blue land. It's tapped. I want to make Construct with Saga. My Saga Construct will be bigger than the rhinos. It's not very good draw here, but it's okay. So I'm deploying these guys, and now the Construct is a 5/5, and I'll pass. It's a 5/5 with protection too. Not a great protection since then it becomes a 4/4, but that's good. Unfortunately, Seat of Synod isn't around. And Urza Saga would go get me a Springleaf Drum. Unfortunately, I didn't draw any Memnite or Ornithopter. Those are very important when you have a. Let's see if they attack with the rhinos. They do. They might still have Brazen Borrower. So I made a 5/5 construct, and wow, that made me block here. Ooh, maybe they didn't realize it was a 5/5. Oh, they have a +1, +1, +0. Okay, that's fine. So they make two extra rhinos and they pump this. Now I get the option of regenerating this construct, which remember that will remove it from combat. Or I can trade. I think I'd rather regenerate it. By regenerating, he removes it from combat afterwards. So yeah, that's an easy play. And now I'll go draw Mishra's Bauble. Yeah, I'm just making another construct here. Pretty easy. That'll be 6/6. And my opponent just has some rhinos. Basically, my opponent deck is relying about just making 4/4s. And with one Urza Saga, I'm able to make 2 5/5s. But why I'm doing so? Because the Darksteel Citadel is our artifacts. So it's pretty great. Now I'm obviously getting Springleaf Drum. This is why when I mean we have enough blue sources, it's because with the Springleaf Drum, sorry, with the Urza Saga, you can go get blue sources here. Now, I'm probably just playing Thought Monitor and see where that gets me. Actually, one sec. Am I able to? Oh yeah, oh wow. I'm able to deploy Sojourner's Companion and tap that. Big boss. Hello, big boss. Thank you so much for the 31st month sub streak. Thank you so much. Hope you're having a lovely day and appreciate this. Such a long support. All right, now I can attack with this construct. Is it bad if my opponent kills my construct? It might be bad. Hello, hello, ally. It might be bad. I'm just passing the turn here. I missed the land drop, but that's okay. They're getting two more rhinos, but they have played already three rhinos, so they only have one left. And so far, I can easily deal with them just in combat without having to kill anything here. But of course, my opponent hasn't played a single cyber card yet. They for sure have let's see what they revealed. They revealed multiple Force of Vigor, which they bought with. They revealed four Force of Vigor with their Cascade cards. They also revealed Fury, but that's not good. They can't attack me and I'll crack my bubble. Have a Voodoo Land, Voodoo Hills on top. That's good. And I'll draw a card for bubble and for turn. Bubble draws bubble as always. Okay, basic island. I like it. Now, where I can start with. I can go Cranium Plating on the Thought Monitor. That's not a bad idea, but that's weak to like Bone Crusher Giant. My opponent plays Zerky's Recall, they can't because they play Bion Outburst Cascade, meaning that they cannot play any two drop or less than that. So I think first thing I do is just cast Thought Monitor, draw two cards. Let's see where that gets me. I've already made a land drop though. I decided to just make basic island land drop. I'll play Mem Knight and I'll draw two more cards with another Thought Monitor here. Okay, I am unable to go Cranium Plating again. I can't just keep on casting thought casts. I think that's where what's what I'm doing actually. Hello, K Prince. Okay, so this was a good turn. Let me go to combat now. And I'll be attacking just for two here. Can't take with construct too. I guess. Is that risky? They killed one of these constructs. They have a 20 power with trample. Yeah, it's still risky. Remember that I'm just dying to a cryptic command here. So I have to just get lethal relatively soon here. I can easily lose this game. Lots of people in play, but opponent with three cards. I know that they're drawing Woodland Foothills. So if they haven't done anything here and they're going to draw Woodland Foothills, I'm not playing around nothing. I'm not playing around anything next turn. I'm going to kill them next turn, okay? Next turn, I'm putting a Cranium Plating on a flyer, and I assume it's lethal because my opponent didn't do anything this turn, and they knew for a fact that they were going Woodland Foothills because I saw their top card last turn. So I call this a win. I call this exclamation mark lose. So this was a kind of a wonderful game. We were stumbling a lot, but Urza Saga just basically single-handedly handled my opponent there. My opponent deck is good. Won the challenge on Saturday in the hands of an Italian player, they know. GP winner, Davide Miani. And then I think he got second in the Sunday challenge. So my opponent deck is definitely a very valid option in Modern. And I'm pretty happy that, you know, my affinity deck got to handle it as well. All right, so they just go Woodland Foothills go. And attack with all, actually. They don't go Woodland Foothills go. But I'm blocking here since I'm dead if I don't. I can take eight. I'll lose two artifacts, so my construct. Yeah, it doesn't really matter. Taking eight here. It's very easy to count the artifacts because you can just count how big is a construct. And then you know how many artifacts you have. Magic Online, it makes it pretty easy. Oh wow, they go Anger of the Gods. Oh wow, the construct barely survived. They are 8-8, but with 7 damage on them because the 4 plus the 3. Oh my god, I was able to win. I'm not cracking the bubble. Internet was fine. I was able to continue the match, and my opponent conceded. All right, so Twitch problem, but we're back. The game ended. My opponent played Anger of the Gods, but thankfully, by exactees, my construct survived to the anger, and I was able to, of course, swing down the attack back, so opponent conceded the game. All right, so we got our first win. We got our first win through the Anger of the Gods. That was a 2-0 over Team Rhinos. And yeah, let's continue with the second round with Affinity. True Affinity. Buongiorno, Sebastian. Hello, Doctor. How was your pre-release weekend? Did you guys attend to any pre-releases? I played two of them, three of them actually, with the Discord one. I played two at my local game store, which I went 2-2 in the first and got to win the second one. 3-0-1, I got a draw. Yeah, underside boarding is a skill. It's not for everybody. It's a skill that you learn the more you get into the game, the more you learn how to underside board. Okay, let's go. You play two? Okay, cool. All right, guys, we are back for round number two with Affinity. I am on the play, which you love to see. And let's go. Etcha Champion is in the sideboard here. Okay, what does this hand do? Well, it doesn't do too much, but we have Urza Saga, so you basically keep it. How am I going to lead? I think I have to lead with Underworld, with Mistfall Bridge. I'll play a couple of bubbles. I might crack them both here. They have Archmage Charm on top. Very good card. I'm not cracking this bubble just now. I'll just keep it around. Kind of have my turn 2 already lined up here. Alright. Memnite's great. I'm able to go Springleaf Drum. I'm able to go Springleaf Drum Memnite. Then I can go Urza Saga, Cranial Plating. Another Memnite. Remember that, like, Drum is basically a Mox Opal in this deck. Obviously it's weaker, but not by that much. And I'm cracking the bubble again as soon as my opponent fetches. And I keep on doing that in my opponent's upkeep. You don't miss triggers online, so you can do that in upkeep. And, yeah, you just make sure that they can't discurse spell you. Warning danger is moved. Okay, they have Opt on top. Why no Downping Sphere for Cascade? It's not. He just adds one mana to a card. It's not great. The Cascade spell. Okay. Saga goes to Chapter 2. I can play Treasure Vault and just make a Construct with the Saga. Nothing exciting, but that's what I have right now. He definitely plays 18 land. They have Field of Ruin, so they won't be able to stop my Construct, unfortunately. And I've often asked, why do I play two islands? Well, this is a case. People just disrupt your lands and mana, your Path to Exile, Field of Ruin. You draw the other land and whatnot. And, you know, getting basics is cool. Okay, let's kick things off with one mana draw two, shall we? Nice. That's a Cranial Plating. I'm able to deploy it. I keep it on a Memnite and swing in for lethal. Let's see if they have what's it called? Force of Negation. Yeah, Plating was exiled. And that's 18 damage. Good game. Turn four. Playing his control deck. I will bring in the Etched Champion for sure. I think once again, you cut the Mirror Enforcer with this deck. Post-sideboard, it's very often that you cut the Mirror Enforcer. Have I made treasures? This is just my third game. I have not made treasures yet. I think it might happen that you make treasures with this land, but it's not that likely. All right, now, do I want to bring in any Metallic Rebuke? The answer is probably yes. What do I cut, though? Become more Sojourner's Companion, or I count them as threats and should never board them out. Probably. I probably should once again board in a couple of this Metallic Rebuke. I can take out a land. And I can take out. Yeah. Alright, let's go with this. Yeah, basically, Enforcer often just goes out sideboard because the game just Puna will obviously handle my artifact, so it will be a little bit slower. And I'm bringing in Etched Champion, which is another slow card. I can't just bring a million slow cards. Okay, they went Flood of Strand go. Yep. I'll play this. I'll put in my play Chalice on 0, so might as well just play them, right? Like Dark Souls Citadel pass. I won't correct the Bubble because Bubble is a land with this hand. I have 3 affinity for artifacts card. So Bubble is actually a land here. Prefer you get Shadow Spear. Yeah, that's a good point. Blood Moon doesn't do that much to this deck. It turns all my lands into Great Furnace, which it's not a big deal. Yeah, the one of Ginger Brute is because you can get it with Urza's Saga. Ginger Brute can be unblockable, and with that with Cranial Plating is a big deal. Alright, again, I'm not cracking the Bubble. Draw. And just pay 2 to draw 2. It's not exciting, but that's what I'm doing here. See, I really wish this was an Emery this turn, because I could have deployed her on turn 1. Instead of just not doing anything. I cannot. Yeah, no, I cannot. Next turn we can go off. Better be aware of a Supreme Verdict too. But that's fine. I don't think it's a big deal. Okay, they play Stony Silence. Now, that would probably just be game over, basically. Because I just can't tap my lands anymore. And I'm very likely unable to win the game. But that's fine. If you play Affinity, you are ready to just lose the game if they play that card. I guess they play Metallic Rebuke, though. Alright, let's play Bubble. Let's play... Do I want to play the Citadel or not? I might slow roll the Saga up until the point where I have enough... where I have enough lands to activate it. I could cast a Metallic... a Thought Cast here. Actually, I'm doing that. Remember, this lands don't add for mana, because I can't tap them. Okay, Field of Ruin is good. Field of Ruin is really good. They go to Teferi, take up. Draw. Okay. I have 4 artifacts, so I still cannot deploy... I cannot deploy my Thought Monitor and such. I still am going to play Saga because my opponent maybe has to kill that with a Field of Ruin. So I have 4 artifacts, yeah. And I'll play Cranial Plating, which, you know, doesn't do anything, but it's an artifact. And again, I couldn't keep up Rebuke, so... It's okay, I'm not expecting to win this game, but I am still clicking the buttons until it ends. Wow, it bounced Ornithopter. That's weird. Okay, I'll draw. Oh, wow. If I draw on a land here, I would have been able to use the Saga. Okay, sure. You can check the deck list on here, Weakspone, or exclamation mark deck. Harbor Live is updated with my Magic Online, and the other, and on tab.gg is updated with my Arena. I have 4 artifacts here, but I mean, we can go off here. So let's start with Ornithopter. It doesn't matter, I'll play Mistball Bridge. I mean, they're basically the same. I can't activate them in the first turn. And now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think they have Cryptic Command, so I'll just lead off with a Sojourner's Companion. This seems like a good bait. Sold. I mean, this is a 4/4. And I'm casting one of this Thought Monitor. My opponent is very likely going to counter this, and that's okay. Oh, wow, they're lighter resolve. Cool. I'm holding this Ornithopter for no reason, but also no reason to deploy it. And I'm passing. Since I can't activate Plating, I don't have lands, I can't crack my Bubble. Okay, they go fulfill the ruin end of turn, which is again strange because if I had a land, I would have activated the saga. But as I can't play Rebuke because of Teferi. I have a 2-2 and a 4-4, but oh wow. I thought I would held up mana for Colony, but they didn't. Okay. I am going to combat. Opponent is on 17. I'm activating. I'm attacking Teferi with this and Top Monitor with this. No, you have to leave with Stony Silence. Let's see what they do here. They play Supreme Verdict at instant speed. Okay. Now, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'll play. I don't want to play Treasure Vault because I might draw Nerzis Saga. I'll play Ornithopter. And now I have 3-6. I'll be able to draw 2 cards with a Thought Monitor. Okay, play another Thought Monitor. Springlip Drum. Not great. I'll play a Memnite, since it has power. I'll play Treasure Vault, which remember does not tap for mana. And I can't activate any of the 2 abilities. And I can't play Etch a Champion. I'll pass the turn. I draw an Urza Saga, can cast this Etch a Champion, that might be good. Right? Can't really attack because they have Colonnade. So I'm just deploying the stuff. And pass the turn. Cannot kill this Teferi. Okay, they go Snapcaster Supreme Verdict. Okay. Yes, Mark, I won the game, yeah. We're 1-0, beat Timur Reina's first round, and now I'm probably going to game 3 against Blue-White Control. Yeah, I should probably concede now. Teferi Hero Dominaria dropped, and that's usually game over. Yeah. All right, good game. The opponent's packing Stone and Silence, which is definitely, definitely very hard card to beat. But that's like kind of like the Affinity Light. On the play, I love more Metallic Rebukes. And I can take out Shadow Spear for sure. I want to bring in Mistbolt Bridge back. I want to have 18 lands on the play. I can take out. So, Welding Jar is good against a Supreme Verdict, so I don't want it to take it out. I'll have Ornithopter. Take a Gingerbread. All right, let's go with this. Affinity best places in the Magic game is when people forget about the artifacts existing. Unfortunately, Hammer Time is definitely one of the best deck in Modern, so it will be hard for my opponents to forget about artifacts existing. So that will be definitely tough. But again, in the first round, my opponent didn't play any artifact hate game too, and the match is very easy. Also, like, you very often just get a free game win, free game one win. It's basically like Dredge Affinity. You very often just win game one, and then you have to hope that your opponent don't draw Cyber to hate game 2 or 3. So it's always like a good place to be. You're shocked that I'm not playing Portable. Yeah, that's a good suggestion, Doctor. I didn't think about a Portable Hole at all. Yeah, Although probably you're new to the Affinity gaming, but you don't have answers to Stony Silence. Affinity never had answers to Stony Silence, and still was like very good in modern for a long time. Okay, this end isn't functional. I have to mulligan. Thinking about this hand here, it is unfortunate that I don't have an answer, a creature going with the drum. I'm definitely keeping, I'm just wondering what to bottom. Might just be Metallic Rebuke here. Now I can bobble myself because if I find the zeros on top, I can go Urza Saga Drum because next turn I'll be able to play Treasure Vault, zero drop, make a construct. So this is one of those rare cases where you are actually just bubbling yourself. Let's see what's on top. At champion, that's not good. Okay, let's go Treasure Vault. Play drum. Play welding jar. The blue black duel. Well, you can move the plating at instant speed and you can cast Dismember. They're just there because it's artifact land. Again, I got paired against blue white with Stony Silence. It's not a very common card. All right, draw, zero drop. Really bad. Really bad. That's fine. I can artifacts land cycling the Sojourner's Companion and just get a land for Treasure Vault. Let's hope they don't drop a Stone of Silence. If they do, I'll concede the game. It's okay. Thankfully, they didn't have it. Let's go get a Darkstone Citadel with a Sojourner's Companion. Saga goes to two. Draw Frogmite. Frogmite is great. Frogmite is a great draw. Makes me be up with Metallic Rebuke. I love it. It's very nice. I'll pass the turn with the Saga up. No need to cast anything. They have Cryptic Command. They have a counter spell up. Oh, sure. The Frogmite is like Memnite, but it's a 2/2 in this deck. It's very rare that you have to pay more than one mana for a Frogmite. Mean, I guess on turn one, it's rare, but. They scryed on the bottom. Good. They play Teferi, Time Reveler. I'm able to make a construct. Actually, do I care about that? Should I counter it? Why should I counter it? I don't care about Teferi. What are they bouncing? Sprinkle Drum to do a card? I don't care about Teferi. I'll let it resolve. If you fear cards, you should just play a different deck. Yeah, this is okay with me. Now I'm untapping and draw. Urza Saga is going to the last chapter, so we have to think about things now. Nah, not really thinking about much. Making a construct. Go get what? Well, I could get Welding Jar. That's probably the best I can get here because of Supreme Verdict. I actually boarded out Shadow Sphere. Cast Froggy for free. Not casting Thoughtcast because I need to keep up mana for Metallic Rebuke. And I have Welding Jar for the Supreme Verdict. The Wuba. I recommend Rome and Tuscany for sure. That area is the most wonderful of the country. Hello, Yellow Pavin. If you're interested in knowing this deck more, at the beginning of the stream, so around maybe like 50 minutes ago, I did a very good deck guide explaining kind of everything in and out. You can always check my VODs, they're free. I wanted to upload this video to Channel Fireball because I love this deck. I think it's so cool and kind of like disappeared with Mox Opal banning. But I believe it's good and I believe that not that many people are playing it. Thank you, Bayan. I was definitely happy. You can go to twitch.tv/andramenguchi/videos. So now again, we have two Welding Jar. So if they play Supreme Verdict and just regenerate my construct and they will kill. I mean, that will kill things. That will kill a Frogmite in 2 jar. That's not bad, but. The Neoform version? That's fun, but I prefer not to draw Neoform. This deck is already clunky sometimes. I don't want to add more things, but it's definitely a fun spin on the archetype. Dark Treasure Vault is basically Darkstone Citadel, and Darkstone Citadel, it's one of the best land of the deck. So Treasure Vault doubles that. It's like if you get, you know, 4 additional Lightning Bolt to your burn deck, you're just happy to play 4 extra Treasure Vault. Okay, they go Cryptic Command main phase. Weird. I can't fight back with a Force of Negation and I just win on the swing back. Am I able to win on the swing back? So far I only have 18 damage. I need an artifact. There it is. Froggy. And that's the win. 9, 9, 20. Good. Oof. Okay, 2-0. Opponent found immediately. Look at this queue. You find opponents so fast on Magic Online Modern. I don't know, but Magic Online Modern might be the queue with the most player right now playing Magic in the online world. All right, so we mulligan to 6 and we keep this, and now I have to decide what to bottom here. I think it's a pretty easy island. Let's go, Mistfall Bridge, Memnite, your turn. Eldrazi Temple. Eldrazi Temple usually mean Thought-Not-Seer on the horizon. But we resolve our Cranium Plating, and now you can take my Thought-Mounted Herber as a Saga going. Okay, no going out there. I'll make a construct with the sag end of turn. Yeah, can't do anything except to make the saga. That costs 3 mana. Again, low is mid, as I said before. If you check out the deck tech, you'll help me not repeat everything I said twice. This video is also probably going up to China Fireballs. Okay, you Thanatsir my Shadow Spear. Yeah, that makes sense. And I'll make a construct. Hard as mantle. Cool. Make a construct. Who do I go get? I can get Springleaf Drum in order to be able to play Thought Monitor this turn. Actually, I have Pardes Mantle into Memnite. It's probably good enough. I'm just getting Welding Jar. And I'll tap for 11. Just getting Welding Jar because, I don't know. There's like no way they can beat what I have going. I don't need to equip. I don't need to do anything. Okay. Bring in Dismember. So usually against the red decks, I bring in Dismember and Champion, take out Thoughtcast and Enforcer. But obviously here, Etch a Champion isn't going to get sideboarded in. So once again, if you think about what to cut, I'll keep the Welding Jar. I really like them. Think I'm taking out Pardes Mantle and two. Can be like one Thoughtcast, one Enforcer. No. So, one lesson that I want to explain, it's that I just don't like to sideboard medium cards. A Dumping Sphere is definitely a medium card. I can't think of a more medium card than Dumping Sphere against Eldrazi Tron. Sure, some games will shut off their Tron piece, but you have to think about Eldrazi Tron as a deck that sometimes does Tron. It doesn't always do Tron. And Dumping Sphere is a card disadvantage card. It's a 2-drop in a deck that I don't know if you've noticed, but you don't have that much mana. So I prefer to keep this in my sideboard. My opponent has a card that shuts my deck off, and that's Karn the Great Creator. Okay? So I have to think about what to do against Karn the Great Creator. And Pithing Needle unfortunately doesn't do it. Because the Karn does against me, it's activated ability. All right, the way I'm handling Karn is by attacking it. I don't want to bring a Metallic Rebuke against Eldrazi Tron. You just don't want to cyber much with this deck. That's basically the thing. Right. This end doesn't have an Urza Saga, unfortunately, but still, it's worth keeping. Have this member, which came from my sideboard. Okay, hopefully they don't go turn three Tron. I will hate that. I am unable to cast a turn one Froggy, but that's okay. I'll play zeros because they have Chalice in there. What am I talking about? I'm definitely able to play turn one Froggy. Hey, I'll pass. Dumping Sphere is also good against Storm. All right, so they got Tron here, which will make this tough. Very tough. So play Chalice, thankfully, one turn later. Now, if you think about whether I want to correct this bubble or not, will help cast my Thought Monitor, but at the same time, I mean, just. What do I need here? What do I need going on for me? I guess there's a saga, that's what I need. I think I'll crack this bubble. They have waste on top, sure. Not great. I'll play a cranial plating and I hope my opponent doesn't drop a card. I won 2, 3, 4, 5, so I couldn't cast Sojourner's Companion, unfortunately. Brownie's Masher, that's very welcome. Ad Nauseam. Ad Nauseam is a deck where I want Dumping Sphere. Special Contortion on my Froggy. Unfortunately, Welding Jar doesn't work on Froggy. Sorry, on Special Contortion, because it regenerates. And this just reduces its toughness below zero, so that's gone. Pretty awkward draws on my side. I know they have a wasting hand. I'm definitely going to dismember that Smasher, but I have to discard a card. I don't think that's a big deal, actually. I will get a land with the Sojourner's Companion. Does it matter if I get Treasure Vault or Darksteel Citadel? I don't think it does. I think a Darksteel Citadel. And I'll pass. Oh, you also versus Saga. Annoying. Bro, this gets countered by the Chalice. I have 5 artifacts. I'm just casting a Sojourner's Companion here. Not pretty, but I have to do. So you see the power of Treasure Bolt and Darksteel Citadel here. And I have a 10-4 with Regenerate Shield up. Could go one of the Artifact Blue Duel, but then it would have taken 5 damage from the Reality Smasher. Opponent can make a Saga as only a 2-2. My opponent doesn't have Artifact Lands, so their constructs are much smaller than mine. Is this a Karn? It's a Walking Ballista. Okay. Just as a 3-3. Nice draw. Where's the Saga? Well, I'm casting the Saga. Remember that I can make a treasure and then crack the treasure for Thought Monitor. But not just yet. Because I only have 3, 4, 5, 6 artifacts. Actually, I could. I could do that. Could do that. Yeah. I think I'm doing it. So sacrifice doesn't make a treasure. Then I'll crack the treasure to play Thought Monitor. Draw 2. I already made my land drop. I can't cast Memnite because of Chalice on 0. Play a drum. And I'll attack for 10 here. Opponent make a construct. It's just a 3-3, so they might chum block with the construct. Yes, Saga was just cast, so I couldn't make a construct. They probably just take 11 here, or they chump block either one of them. They can chump block and shoot the Sojourner's Companion too. That's probably a good play. But yeah, passing because I can't deploy my zeros. Now they're pinging the Ballista. Forgot to use my Jar. When it will Ballista again and it dies. Oh, it doesn't? Okay, then I'll pass the turn. They should have removed it in response. Now they can't blow it up anymore because the regeneration shield removes all the damage that was on it. Part of the regenerating ability. And now let's see what they go get with Urza Saga. They can get a destroy. They can get a card that destroys me. That's Basilisk Caller. Hope they don't have such card. But they probably do, so that'll be tough. But it's okay. I can lose game two. Affinity very often loses game two. Okay. Now, Ballista with three counters on it if they pay the mana. They tap me. I'm taking. And now Walking Ballista plus Basilisk Caller, it's like pow pow pow. And maybe I should get Pithing Needle in my deck. Alright, I can see the game. Good game. Opponent went Tron on the play. That's fine. I'll lose to that. Again, I don't want Damping Sphere. Wonder if I should bring in Pithing Needle though. I will. I'll remove a one thought cast. Maybe the mirror force. Yeah, very often if you don't play much modern, you just get across synergies new every time, and that's very, very pretty. Okay, this is a very Urza Saga heavy lane. The power of Urza Saga shows up now, and you can be like, wait, how strong is this card? Is this card strong enough to make you keep a hand like this? Well, it seriously might be. It seriously might be. I think I'll go ahead and keep this in. Card will make so that from turn three on, I will be just making construct every turn. And well, let's just hope it works. It's not seer proof. It is. My opponent is also a streamer. Cool. Again, we play around Chalice of the Void, so just deploy all your zeros. I don't need to crack the bubble. I already have like my turns lined up with the saga. Actually, I probably will. Oh, did I reveal? Yeah, at least I can kill Emrakul Woodcaller, yes. Okay. All right, that's a tiny little walking ballista. Let's see if they have natural Tron there. Oh, Pithing Needle is my draw. This is awkward now. I mean, my opponent might have thought not here with the what's it called? Eldrazi Temple, but I'm hoping they don't. So I'm just playing Darksteel seated on pass. I'll just deploy Pithing Needle next turn to not go off curve. Iobugin is banned, so it's only Eldrazi Temple that makes my opponent cast Thanatsir next turn. Or, of course, there's this Tower. Okay, thankfully they don't. So they just have a second plant. Good enough. Now, I know I have Thanatsir in hand, and it looks like they are passing the turn. Which I appreciate. Nope. They're playing Ratchet Bomb. Oh wow. So Ratchet Bomb is able to blow up all my artifact, all my construct, and also the Thopter, and also the Walking Ballista. Now I'll go to my main phase. This is very weird. Because the needle could have been tutored up with the saga now to blow up the ratchet bomb. Unfortunately, the needle is in my hand. And I'm in a spot where if I make a construct with the saga, they just blow up the bomb. So I basically can't. make a construct with the saga. It is a very unfortunate turn. I basically don't have a turn this time. It is weird. It's very weird. Don't get Weld in Jar, but like, what do I do with a construct? Do I make a construct now? Because the saga is dying now. I'm actually upset. I'm actually upset. All right, I don't make a construct. I don't think it's a good play. And I'll let the saga die. Let's see if they blow up the bomb in response. They are going to blow up the bomb in response. Yep. The land don't die because they're indestructible. Also says no land. So yes, unfortunately I can't do anything about this. And now what do we go get with this? I'm very, very afraid of Karndegrit Creator. If Karndegrit Creator comes down, I can't tap my lands anymore. And Karndegrit Creator is coming down. Like, it is. Think I'll, it's a terrible spot I'm in. Terrible spot I'm in. And get Ginger Brute. And I'll need all the Karndegrit Creator. Can't make a construct with this saga. It's just such a terrible turn. I've basically been like time walk with this Ratchet Bomb. Terrible, terrible spot I'm in. Crazy. How much does this cost? Three. I don't have three. I'll lose. I lose, and what can I blame about my loss? Had I played Urza's Saga on turn three instead of a land, I would have been able to make a construct, and they couldn't make the play they made. So that was the thing to blame about my loss there. The fact that I decided to. All right, Island is a good draw, though. Island is a good draw, though. But the fact that I decided to play Urza's Saga over. Sorry, Dark City over Urza's Saga there is the thing to blame, I think. Now, what am I going to get here? Remember, I can't activate anything, and they blast zone on one, which can blow up both the Pitting Needle and the Ginger Brute. I can't activate the Weld and Jar. Am I just getting a Memnite? Memnite doesn't do much. Think it's just better than the rest, though. Make a construct now with the saga, and I'll attack Karn down to three. Yeah, if this game I play is a saga on turn three instead of Dark Souls Citadel, it's just completely different. Is a Burn Coil? A Walking Ballista for three. Still unable to kill the Karn though, unfortunately. Yeah, I've seen it, Sebastian. It's beautiful. What am I going to get with this Urza Saga? I'm not going to get any X1s because they're dying from the Walking Ballista since that has to chump. Good game, though. We've learned. We have learned. We definitely have learned this game. Well, I can get like a Shadow Spear if the game continues and I'm able to kill the Karn. Actually, that dies to Blast Zone. I'm getting a bubble, whatever. It doesn't really matter. Can't activate the cards. And it pass. It's like a ghost to two. But let's see what they have. I mean, they have three cards. They can also blow up the needle and plus one on the bubble. They really want to just do some action, but they can also make a construct, which is just a 1/1. Yeah, 1/1 Ballista. Dismember. Okay. So looks like we were able to kill the Karn. I think I'm actually just letting them like chum block with the Saga and the Ballista. Oh, wow. They chum blocked, but what about the Froggy? A 4? Will you put a counter on it? Interesting. Hello, BG Nico. Okay, so their card is down. I'm actually able to now use my bubble again. Ooh. I guess I will later. This will make a treasure. Don't think that does much. Right, so let's bubble them in upkeep. What do I see? I see a Cavern of Souls. I love to see a Cavern of Souls there. So opponent doesn't have much because they didn't have much. Oh wow, they just tapped the Saga for mana. And they got Expedition Map. Oh no, do they have like an Ulamog? Looks like they have a Ulamog here. They must have an Ulamog here. That's, yeah, they have exactly 10 mana to Ulamog me. Four. Another Karn. It's giving me the option to make a treasure with this treasure vault. It doesn't change anything because I can't activate the treasure in any way, so. Sure, you can get Karn. Remember, you can't activate it. Or you can blow up the Blast Zone. Will you play Reality Smasher? Okay. So my construct can be a 10-10. Yeah, well, I guess I'll let it be a 10-10 in case they have a dismember. And I'll attack with the construct on Karn. And where does Froggy go? Froggy goes on Karn. I don't care if they, you know, I don't care if they kill the Froggy. They cannot remember blow up the Blast Zone and get like Ensnaring Bridge. I would beat Ensnaring Bridge. I don't know. I don't. Squillo! Thank you so much for the... Alright, let me turn down the volume. I didn't hear the volume. I hope you guys did. Thank you so much, Squillo, for the support for the second month. Going in as a bridge. They have a Karn. And they have a tonnage here. Okay. Can I get out? I will concede the game. All right. Big regrets about this game for not playing that Urza Saga on turn two, but nonetheless, this was a beautiful game to play. All right. Hello, hello, hello. Sguilo, let me turn out the volume so that when my next sub arrives, we can hear it. All right, good morning. Good morning. We're currently 2-1 in this league. Going well. I just picked up a tough loss now to Congrid Creator. I did make a maybe not a best keep, but still, it was a good fight. How do they end up winning? Well, they have Karn going on. I'm sure they have like a Walking Ballista in the sideboard. And my deck just couldn't I just couldn't deal with the bridge anymore. Yeah, as I said multiple times, Karn, Stone of Silence. There's a lot of hate cards for Affinity, and yeah, my take is just to lose to those. But those don't show up, the deck crashes. We beat Team of Rhinos in blue white in first and second round, and now lost to Eldrazi Tron in the third. All right, fourth round on the draw against Simo. My land is land heavy. All right, point is Fling Lures of the Dream then. I was going to say, my land is land heavy, but it does have an Urza Saga. And my take on those hands is to keep them. I am treating Urza Saga as like a Bazaar of Baghdad in the Bazaar deck. See, if I have it in my opening hand, I keep. Okay, Regavan. Unfortunately, I am unable to stop it on turn one. So I just play Bridge. Paradise Mantle pass. And the Ragavan connects. Let's see what they flip. They flipped another Urza Saga. Okay. Now that's access to 3 mana already. Ooh, they play Overgrown Tomb. Dothi Voidwalker. Okay. And Thoughtseize. Fine. Now they can cast a card at this card because of Dothi Voidwalker. It's a very good curve for my opponent on the play. Definitely deploy the Urza Sagas. Next turn, I have to start making Construct. I'm just casting Froggy here. How was my pre-release weekend? It was lovely. It was lovely. I love to play pre-release. My local game store is great, so I always enjoy playing there. Okay, so they killed my Froggy with an Unholy Heath, and they attacked me for 5. Exiling what? They exiled the Weldon Jar. And they played Tarmogoyf. Strong. Very strong. I'm on 13. I can make a 4/4 construct with my saga. I have 3 cards. Yeah, I found the Demelec. I found the 3-drop that returns to hand that combos with Alurin. Pretty happy. All right, the thought sees me. That's okay. You'll take my Cranial Plating, number 2. Disco Spell aren't very good against this deck. Oh wow, they exiled Kroxa. Sorry, they milled Kroxa. That's lucky. Nice. And now they can, of course, attack with the 4/5 Death Shadow. And Tarmogoyf can also come across because it's a 4/5. Because they milled the Kroxa with the Urgot Channel. Our opponent's playing well. Yep, I can't block. So I'll go to 7. Start 6. I'll make a construct. And now, what can I do? My constructs are large. Let's remember that. Gingerbread. So what I can do now is getting the shadow sphere. I keep it in a construct and send a big attack. They have under the exile nothing relevant. Then I have a chum blocker in Ginger Brute. Unfortunately, I can't gain life off of it, but that's fine. How much life do I gain? Well, I gain 1, 2, 3. So I gain 7 up to 13. And then I have a blocker. I think it's reasonable. Yeah, I'm not making a construct here. Attack for 8. And my opponent, well, they die to this combo next turn. And I'm on 14. Now, if they kill my Ginger Brute, they have 12 damage. They have 10 plus 2, 12. They have Croak Saga, but they have a spell to discard. So let's see. I mean, Urza Saga is a one-card combo. Because it makes a construct and it puts a Shadow Sphere on it. Of course, this deck is the best Urza Saga deck because you have all this artifact land that makes the construct huge. So it's just a one-man army, the construct. Otherwise, if you play the planes, the construct isn't that big, but in this deck it is. Hey, and the opponent knows I have a Cranium Plating in hand. So they know that I'll be able to... Actually, they don't have mana to cast Froxa, never mind. So next turn, if they don't deal with this construct, the game will be over. How can they deal with this construct? That's a good question. Oh wow, they're casting a Thoughtcast, looks like. They're sacrificing the Thoughty Voidwalker to flashback Thoughtcast, it looks like. Yeah, that's cool. They're drawing 2 cards. They discard a Thoughtcast with one of their Thoughtsies there. They mill Bolt. They think that Bolt isn't good enough. Save them here. You're welcome, Knight. Buongiorno, Kira. So they have 2 cards. They need like, well, Call Against Command would be very good. Probably puts me to sleep. Because I don't have a beater anymore. Yeah, that's what they have. Alright, good for you. So they kill my 2 creatures, and I don't have anything anymore. They can attack me for 10. I go to 4. And then, again, at this point, I don't think I have any outs. I guess I can draw 4-4, but no, that's not good enough anymore. Yeah, Kulagas Command, I think, was their only out there. And the opponent looked through a lot of cards with a Dragon's Rage Channeler. They played very well this game. Does this help me at all? It's a 5-5. This Tarmogoyf is a 5-6. That's unfortunate. I'm also missing 1 mana to go plating a Kip and also keep the Shadow Spear. Because that would require me 5 and I only have 4. Well, let's just do it regardless, because, I mean, I don't have much to do anyway. I'm not dead, technically, so I can just keep on clicking buttons here. Maybe next turn I'll draw, like, some top monitors in a row. It's kind of funny to see my opponent's Boris Sate, a Welding Jar, and or an Adopter. Wilding Jar would have been amazing if I had it, instead of this Paradise Mantle. But Paradise Mantle is basically your 5th Springleaf Drum. I didn't need it in this game because I already had lands. I mean, I kept a land heavy end. Armgrove is a five. It's really weird that I made a blue on green. It didn't used to be this way. It didn't used to be blue on green. Yeah, but it could be a Wilding Jar, as I play two Wilding Jar, one Paradise Mantle. So if I think that this is actually better than this, I would change the number around, but I don't think so. I think that a mix is okay. Oh wow, I'm actually dead on board. I can just random a Crooks and I'm dead. Yeah. I didn't think about it. I should have probably kept this in my hand. But it doesn't really matter. I mean, my opponent is going to attack with Tarmogoyf if I have to chump block it. Yeah. Alright, good game. Losing game one with this deck shouldn't happen. You should always win every game one. So whenever that happens, it really makes you feel like you're not winning the match. And against these Emery deck, sorry, Emery deck. Against these, why did I say Emery? Ragavan deck, I'm taking out Thoughtcast and Mirror Enforcer for Dismember and a Champion. That's my sideboarding. And y'all ship it back. Yeah, Affinity should never really lose any game one. Etch a Champion is definitely hard to deal with, unless my opponent is like Shatterstorm. It doesn't die to Shattering Spree, it doesn't die to K-Command, and etc. But it's very, very good. Because if you put like a plating on the Etch a Champion, it's usually game over in one or two attacks. In this game, I lost game one because my opponent was on the play with a very good curve and the very timely K command, but that's fine. Like, my opponent deck is one of the best in the format. All right, game two, they go for the 61 special, and I'm opening a good end. Not an amazing end, but hoping they boarded out their Discourse spell. I have a turn two champion. Actually, that's not true. I don't have a turn two champion. I miscounted. I think I'm still going for Drum. And the reason being, I want to top deck a zero and be able to cast champion on turn two. And if I don't draw anything relevant, I can still go brute attack. Let's see what they do. Swamp. All right, Thoughtseize. Okay. Now best draw is probably Urza Saga. My hand isn't great. All right. Complete Ginger Brute. And, well, I guess I can just cast the Mistball Bridge. Because, like, they know about it with the bubble anyway, so I don't need to. I don't need to. Old. Just play the top land. And now I'm just sitting here. Hope they have a lot of Discourse Spell in hand, or at least one or two more. That's kind of the risk of having Discourse Spell in a matchup like this, where everything I have is so cheap. So with Treasure Bolt, I have 5 mana, so I can cast. Sorry, I have 6 Artifact. Yeah. With this deck, you basically always want to draw Cranioplating or the Thoughtmonitor, or the Urza Saga. Those are definitely the 12 cards that you want to draw the most. Okay, they play a Tarmogoyf as a 4/5. Cool. Draw. Dismember. Okay. So this member isn't like bold, so it should kill the Starma boy. If I know the rule correctly. I hope I know the rules correctly. Turns out I did not know the rules correctly, and this Starma boy survived. Alright, this is the Shane concession. It's important to shame concede in Magic. Especially when you play for, you know, no stakes. You should take pride in the shame concession. Okay, this hand is good. Fifth match on the play. Let's go. Doctor. Urza's Saga. Springlip Drum. Doctor. Welding Jar. That's it. Unfortunately, I can't do anything more. I don't have much going on, though. If I don't draw land to make a construct, it'll be tough to turn two. But turn two will probably once again just be Cycle Sojourner's Companion. Let's see what GG does. GG, you want to play Magic with me? All right, they do. All right, Mesa. The Underworld Cookbook. Okay, cool. All right, Mistful Bridge. What happens now? It certainly happens that I'm not able to do anything, I think, because I only have 5 artifacts. I'll just play Bridge, and I think I'm just artifact land cycling the Sojourner's Companion pass here. Oh, never mind. I don't know how to count. I'm able to cast something. I guess that this member really just took all my brain power away. All right. Thankfully, I recovered with a quick 5+2 math. All right. All good. All good. I could have played Sojourner. All right, chat. Let's clean my head and let's keep on making mistakes in Magic. It's so brutal because you keep on making them after you made them. Could have played a 0 mana 4/4. Chose not. All right. Next turn, I'll be able to make a construct with the Saga since they have 3 mana. Okay, what is my opponent going to do? Asmoranma Karika Destin or Kaldakar? Nope. Okay. Good. They drop my up their bubble and then I'll make a construct. Then 8/8. What do I go get here? I don't have needle in the main deck, unfortunately. It could have been put a needle in the main deck. Am I just getting the spear? Yeah. I can't keep it right now, but it's still like a pretty solid solid play. Bolt. Do I want to regenerate it? Keep cost two to equip, so I'll just pass. All right, let's go game two. Definitely bringing the needle. I don't know about the lanterns. I don't think I'm gonna bring in the champion because of the Urza Saga. So let's just bring a needle for. Do I want to bring a lantern? So my opponent has for sure the Overwatch's Daredevil Underworld Cookbook combo, but I already have a needle for that. I don't think this is a matchup where I want to also bring the lantern in. What about this member? This member kills Ragavan, it kills Osmo. Yeah. Think I'll need this member. I think I'll take out Thoughtcasts, maybe like a mix between these. These are definitely my weaker cards. So yeah, let's just take out like this. Yeah, you can name Osmo or you can name the cookbook. Naming the cookbook is sometimes better, but you can name Osmo for sure, yeah. Cascading with a lot of zeros or ups in your deck isn't amazing. Okay, Dizend seems good. Not amazing, but good. This is why I don't love to overload on Thoughtcast, because you don't have that many sources for it. Yeah, the bad cascade is definitely a thing. Okay, they go Blackleaf Cliff Cookbook. Okay, draw. Yeah, not doing much, just casting my zeros. Playing one of those artifact land and pass. Unfortunately, no froggy. School up, Yaffe! Thank you, School up, Yaffe. I'm sorry you don't hear very well. Alright, Asmurana Makarika, that's in our Caldecar. That's in. And that can already blow up a thing with the food. Strong start for my opponent. With two cookbook, the Overworld Chase Devil, the Osmo. This is not a game I'm going to win. The Osmo deck really has some good draws if they, like, draw their cards in the right way. Sometimes it doesn't do anything like the previous game, sometimes it just does it all. Really good. Do you think this member is better than Galvanic Blast in this deck?
Yes.
Okay, let's see if they want to blow up one of my artifacts. I mean, they could. Yeah, they kill the Memnite, sure. They have like a kill spell every turn with the Osmo, which is definitely something very good. I chose to play Saga because, sure, I could have played Treasure Vault, Froggy, and cast Sojourner's Companion, but it doesn't do much. It simply doesn't do much. Here, now the question is, do I want to Affinity Uncycle this? No. Just casting Froggy, pass. I just need to, like, put my saga online and get needle as soon as possible. My opponent is going to kill two creatures every turn. Every of their turn, because they can just discard this. I don't think Yurtz's Saga is going to get banned soon. I think modern metagame is very balanced right now. Really just a piece of art. What Modern Horizons has done to Modern is, I don't think any Magic set ever. Wonderful. Okay, Asma's attacking. That makes sense. Okay, I draw. Remember, I can make a construct. The construct they make, it's very large because every time they tap this, they get something. Okay, so my opponent deck also is a very good Urza's Saga deck. Play Drum, play Treasure Vault, and I just want to make a construct. I don't want to cast anything from my hand. As soon as I can cast construct, it's better than anything. Okay. I just don't want to cast Sojourner's Companion. Because if I cast Sojourner's Companion, they kill it with the Asmo, right? And next turn I'm getting the needle for the Asmo. Then when I needle the Asmo, I'll be able to deploy my companion. My opponent constructs can be as big as 9/9 because I can just tap the cookbook to get 2 food. I think that Channel Fireball does that, Mongoose. I remember it used to be like that. I think they didn't change it, so it used to be like that. If you buy from Channel Fireball and your card get banned, maybe like in a few months or something. I don't know. You can maybe check what their policy, but I do remember when they like banned Aquan Once Upon a Time and stuff like that. They were proud to say that they had a refund policy. A 30-day deal. Yeah, that's it. Oh wow, my opponent goes needle. Oh no, I didn't think about it. Oh wow, the name's Maki Katsu. No, why? The name's Springleaf Drum. No, mine ability don't work. I'm painting needle. Whatever. I'm happy. I mean, I lost the match because of a punt. It's okay if I win a match because of a punt. It's only fair, right? To balance things out. Okay. Now, my opponent has 4 cards in hand. I only know which is Daredevil. Construct is very large. Because of Treasure Vault is an artifact, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So my construct is exactly a 7-7 to be bigger than the 6 damage from the Asmo. That's good. That's good. Let's see what they do here. Okay. I think they don't know the fact that I can make a construct here. But I'm not... of course, I'll use the drum. I don't need Neodogawa. I know. Needle is a very old magic card. If you're new to the game, you still get got by Needle every time. But the more you play with Needle... or against Needle, the more you know that it says no mana ability. Yeah, they said, very funny. Guess I learned something today. Cool. See, that's exactly how you should play Magic. With the learning, will. Okay, they killed my Frog Might. That's still very good. Because that makes the construct a 6/6 and they can bolt it with the food. Will I ever come in future? Right now, I don't have any will to compete in Magic events. But maybe in future, it will happen, Scolapiatti. Yeah. I can come back in the future. I don't know what will happen. Future is a very long-term plan. And right now, I'm enjoying my local life. Okay, so let me think if I want to chump block or not. I don't think so. I need the top doors here. I don't think I can chump block. What does the needle even do, though? I name Asmo? They just make a million food. Well, let's start by just making a construct, because that has to happen. How about I needle the Underworld cookbook? Yeah, doctor. Gira's store is still stocked. I mean, I bought everything he had, but there's so many people just buying packs and selling the cars every time. Every time I go there, it's very good. He just does such a good price on just buying the cards that he's always stocked. Not sure if you can buy from him though. He doesn't really sell online. Especially cards that are like high requests. Yeah, I think Needle stopping Construct from getting bigger is my first priority now over stopping Asmo to bolt me. Also remember, without the cookbook, it's very hard for them to make food. Thank you, Lekagum, I appreciate it so much. Thank you so much, Lekagum. You upgraded your badge to a Tortellino badge. Yeah, it's the product with the best EV all time. Like, if you are one of those people that just love to open boosters, the set boosters are insane. This weekend, I've seen so many people just opening set boosters and going up. Like, of course, if you buy one, you can break. But if you buy, like, more than one, everyone always found something of value. It's kind of strange. I think the only reason is that the cards are... I don't know, it's too expensive. I don't know. It's very strange. Anyway, the Planet Cookbook, which it doesn't do anything. They got a Shatter Spear, but that's fine. The attack with 2 11-11 Construct. Mm-hmm. What do I do? I mean, I guess I lose. That's what I do. But other than that, is there anything else I can do? No, not really. Not really. I should probably just take this damage. I mean, I guess I can continue, but... I can't compete with those constructs. Alright, good game. They made a mistake, Max. Alright, let's go game 3. This will be the last game of today. Sorry, of today, Affinity Modern. Then I will switch to Arena. We are 2-2. Going to the last game against Asmo Food. Let's go. Set booster? No, collector booster. My local game store doesn't have collector booster. He says that they're impossible to get, or like, I guess very hard to get. Set boosters and just regular booster too. We're 2-2. Going to the finals. Hello, Just Wiggles. Thank you. Yeah, my time to go live is usually in the European morning. By usually, I mean every day in the European morning. I took a took a week off last week. I was with my girlfriend in vacation in Siena. But now I'm back. Every day. All right, let's keep the Zen. The Zen is good. I have my platings. This is one of those very rare cases where you cast the Saga on turn one. It can go badly. Your opponent can bolt the Ornithopter and you can't activate it, but you can also just top deck a zero. If they don't, you start making constructs on turn two. So let's hope they don't have a removal spell for my Thopter. I could have played it slower, I know, but I decided to play like this. Also, I don't have a third land anyway if they kill my Ornithopter. Okay. Yeah, it didn't go well. My play didn't pay off. I managed to not make a single construct off of the Saga. I maybe took a too risky line and I got punished. But it is. Yeah, also I think the image 2 is just such a good value that you shouldn't really keep it sealed. You want to hold Ornithopter until turn 2. That's a good point. I wanted to keep up this member for the Asmo turn 1, but your point makes more sense. Steal it. Yes, you're very right. If I didn't want to dismember the Asmo turn 1, which, I mean, I guess that would have been that was an option, but your play of playing around removal spell was much better than playing around this member because the fail rate that I did was so much higher. So yeah, you're definitely right. I should have held the Thopter until turn two. And opponent couldn't have matched with a bolt. I guess and they couldn't even bolt afterwards because then I have two creatures, so I can still Saga again. So yeah. Okay, they do this. I'm definitely going to get Pithing Needle on the Saga. I mean, it depends what I draw, but I'm probably going to get Pithing Needle on the Saga. Stopping the cookbook is so important. I don't really understand my opponent deck, though. It's strange. Anyway, let's draw. Top Monitor. Can I cast it? I guess I can cast it if I find a zero creature. Yeah, I think I have to cast Odd Monitor now, change of plans. Because otherwise I don't have blue mana. So I have to get creature now. What creature am I getting? Well, I can get a Ginger Brute, or I can get an Ornithopter. Ornithopter carries the sword very well. Yeah, I think, but I guess I have Odd Monitor to carry the sword. No, I still think that Ornithopter is the best pickup here. Okay, so I have 4, 5. Probably can play Crania Plating. This is game 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I have 5 artifacts. If I play Crania Plating, that'll be the 6th. And I'll play Thought Monitor. I'll play Ornithopter. And I can't decide whether I want to dismember this Dragon's Rage Channel or to prevent my opponent from keep on surveilling, or I can keep this dismembering and for the Asmurano Mercadicadas in our Kaldakar, which is actually what I'm going to do. Keeping the Thopter and passing the turn here. I'm not afraid of this Dragon's Rage Channel right now. If it becomes a 3-3, that's fine. I'm just not attacking with the Thought Monitor. One of that top hated the challenge. Okay, cool. Interesting deck. Never seen anything like this. It's funny because at the beginning of the format, everyone was so mad about Overchase Daredevil, Cookbook, Asmo combo. But then that deck disappeared. Nice to see it back in a totally different shape. kind of like the beauty of modern. The fact that there's like no premium event just basically makes people go crazy about decks, and then the decks just aren't very good. But so many people talk about them that they kind of become good just because so many people play them. For example, Green White Alien, right? That deck disappeared, and it was the best deck before Modern Horizons 2. It's kind of funny to me that that deck just straight up disappeared. Okay. Wow, they just pass. I love it. Thoughtcast. Well, that's a great start. Let's start with the Thoughtcast, shall we? What might I draw to? Why am I draft is so powerful when it happens? I would also the top 8? Nice. I mean, not that I have ever any relationship with Eliota. I've actually never played that deck. It was just, I just found the thing funny. I am not going to play Saga until the second main phase. Well, what I'm doing here is to equip the Thought Monitor and go to combat. Now, my opponent doesn't have flying with this. They have to turn the Delirium first. So, I'm going to attack for lethal. And if they do something, for example, they discard a creature, this gets Delirium. It was a game 3, like, started playing Sojourner's Companion because that pumps both my Thopter and my Thought Monitor. Alright, I'm attacking for 22. My opponent is unable to block right now, but I'm sure they will attempt to, making this Dragon's Rage Channeler flying. Wow, is this a Kooligan's Command? Buongiorno, Lunax. Alright. Aloha. K-Command wants to do that. Yeah, that's a strong play. I'll let you surveil first. And then I'll dismember. Now, K-Command blows up the things. And they don't take any damage. They're on 3 cards. I'm on 0. Because I'll be playing the Xerza Saga. It's strong. And I'll move it on to a Ornithopter. Or move the, sorry, the plating onto an Ornithopter. I haven't moved the Cranium plating at instant speed yet. It's quite hard. It requires that you have 2 black, which is not easy to achieve in this deck. Yeah, that's funny. Yeah, infinite life isn't really a thing on Magic Online. But nonetheless, that deck is still strong. Okay, let's see what they do with the construct. I want to probably they have Asmo now. I tried to like slow. Oh wow, they just got a Big Game Hunter. Oh, that's funny. Big Game Hunter. Okay. The 3 mana 1/1, and if you discard a card, you can pay 1, and they're able to kill a thing on ATB. Strong. Do they have Asmo too? They have a Braid on my plating. I don't have anything left. I guess I have Saga. Alright, I'll put a manage to kill everything I got. Which was definitely impressive by them. I have a lot of things going on there. Okay. No, I don't like the music on the channel. Am I attacking with a Memnite? Not really. I guess I am, yes. Then I chump block my construct with a Game Hunter. So I'm okay if they trade. Well, they have 1 card in hand. They shouldn't have Asmo. By the way, they played They shouldn't have overchased Daredevil. They can still, like, get back a creature with the cookbook, so. But I have my saga. I'm feeling okay, not great, like I was, like, last turn. Like, last turn, I really thought I could never lose a 2-plating, a 2-2 flyer, a 4-4, and they have nothing. But they were able to just kill all they got. Alright, Season Pyromanzo. Cool. They have one card in, and hope it's not another Big Game Hunter. It's a Bone Shard. Okay. They draw two cards and make an Elemental. Strong card, Pyromancer. And Cookbook. They have one card. Nice. It's not a Saga. I make a Construct. It's very good. It's very strong, this Construct. It's a 7-7. Now I'm going to main phase. And I'm making another Construct. But now the question is, what do I go get? Pithing Needle on the Construct? Or just the Sphere? It has to be the Sphere. It has to be the Sphere. Lifelink Trample is too strong of an ability. So Puna now takes 11, maybe a little bit less, but Trample still like makes them take a lot and I gain a lot. And I have two Construct and a good equipment, so I feel good. Right, you take 9, I gain 11, that's it. I want to move the sword, I can't, so you can go. And even if they draw Osmo here, alright, what do they discard? Bloodcrypt, sure. Even if they draw Osmo here, I still have two Construct, so I can only kill one of them. I think that's it. Shadow Sphere. I mean, not Shadow Sphere. Urza Saga. Urza Saga seals the deal. Urza Saga is the reason why this deck is playable. Alright, I just draw land. They can use the Cookbook to get something. Oh, they can get Big Game Hunter with Cookbook. Drawing the fifth land wasn't bad here. Opponent can pay 4, sacrifice this, get back Big Game Hunter, and then they can discard it to pay 1 for Madness. So my opponent's still around. They aren't dead yet. They are not dead yet. Impressive. So, actually, yeah, Froggy. Now I kind of wish I just got Pithing Needle instead of what I actually got. Yep. I think I want to move the Shadow Spear around here now, right? Because my opponent can just kill the one that I have, so might as well just guarantee the 1 damage. But yeah, very impressive. Opponent's still around with the Big Game Hunter. They have to fetch down to 9, they take 1 of the top there, they go down to 8. And they can chump block a Construct and kill the other one. Oh, maybe they don't have more basics? Kinda hope so, actually. Nope, they still have basics. Okay. Ooh, they make this play instead! I didn't see this play, cool. Okay, so opponent decide to slow play their Big Game Hunter thing and just chump. Fine with this. I'm fine with this. Yeah. Okay. I guaranteed my 1 damage. I mean, opponent has to do that next turn. I could have done that play next turn, so that's okay. I still got 1 damage in. They said GG. I guess I'll say GG. Maybe they didn't see the line of Big Game Hunter, but anyway, we got our 3-2, so just making a recap here. We beat Teemer Thoughtful's Blue-White Control, a loss to Eldrazi Tron, but that game 3, I still have regrets. We lost pretty convincingly to Jund Shadow, and then we beat this very strange red Asmo deck. But yeah, this deck has been fun. I hope you guys enjoyed the league, and yeah, just...